the last part of the proofs that we're showing here in this lecture is the mathematical equal scheme, which we call codes in the Torah, mathematical equal minimal schemes. For us to understand better what it means codes, I will describe your story. Let's say I would like to send a spy to a foreign country, and the spy will have to send me information. Obviously, he cannot write exactly what he wants to tell me, because if they catch it, they know right away who is the spy. So we agreed that he's going to send it to me in a certain code. For instance, every 50th letter in the story, I will circle and I will count it as a part of the story. The rest of the letters are not important. Inside the Torah, which was given 3,318 years ago, we found today thousands of mathematical equal schemes that giving us indications, knowledge about famous incidents that happened in this generation and the previous generations. The interesting part in it, that when the Torah was written, God was hiding information inside the text in mathematical brilliant way that was giving us information about what's going to happen 3,000 years later. Everybody understand, no human being has knowledge what's going to happen a week later or even a day later. But the Torah told us many, many incidents in exact details and dates. The only way is that it was hidden inside the Torah in mathematical, beautiful order. Obviously, scientists have checked the Torah, they checked the book of Genesis, and that's enough, obviously. And they came with a final conclusion that the book of Genesis is full of information hidden inside in statistical, mathematical order, with no doubt that a human being was not able to write such a book. So, as we review inside the Torah, we're going to find information that will surprise us very much. For instance, in the book of Exodus, we have information about the famous rabbi that lived 850 years ago in Egypt. His name was Rabbi Moshe ben Maimon, son of Maimon, known as Maimonides. He was a famous doctor, a famous astronomer, mathematician, philosopher, very, very famous. As a matter of fact, they have his statue in Washington as one of the 18th greatest people ever lived when it comes to science and philosophy. But the interesting part is that 2400 years approximately before the Rambam was born, God was hiding information about him inside the text in very clever, sophisticated way. As we review, the Torah speaking about Moses, God sending Moses to Pharaoh and say, don't worry, Pharaoh will not listen to you, but I'm going to do it because I want everybody to know the strong arm of God. And inside the text, we see the word Moshe, which is the names of the Rambam. His name was Moshe. He lived in Egypt, so the word Mitzrayim, Egypt, is in the same page. He was the heart doctor of the king of Egypt. So the word heart of Pharaoh, the heart of king of Egypt, is inside the text. Then we have four words that gives us the abbreviation of Rambam. Resh, Mem, Bet, Mem, Rabot, Moftai, Be'eretz, Mitzrayim. Four words in the Torah. The only time in the entire Torah that you have four words in the right order. Resh, Mem, Bet, Mem, which is four letters, that gives the name Rambam, which was his nickname, his title. That's right here. There's no other place that there are four words that are giving us this order. Resh, Mem, Bet, Mem. But the interesting part is that this is where we find the code. And today, with the help of the computer, it takes us seconds to do it. Without the computer, it will take us hundreds of years because of the way, speed of the computer. So this is what it says. Vayomer Hashem el Moshe, and God told Moses, from the letter Mem of the word Moshe, we circle that with a circle, and we count 50 letters. We're going to receive the letter Shin. If we count 50 letters, we're going to get the letter Nun. If we count 50 letters, we're going to get the letter Hey. It gives us the word Mishnah. If we go a little bit down, we find the letter Taf. We count 50 letters, we get Vav. We count 50 letters, we get Resh. We count 50 letters, we get Hey. So we got the word Mishneh Torah. What's Mishneh Torah? That's the name of the book that the Rambam wrote 850 years ago. The subject of the book mainly is the 613 laws that we have to keep. So it's very interesting. Because if we're reviewing the Torah, we're going to find that 2400 years before the Rambam was born, God showed us information inside the Torah. Mem, Shin, Nun, Hey, Mishneh in equals key, Torah in equals key. But the interesting part is that between the word Mishneh and the word Torah, we have a large skip, much higher than 50. If we count how many letters we have between the word Mishneh to the word Torah, 613 letters. Unbelievable. Let's conclude. 2400 years before the Rambam was born, the Torah knew there would be a person named Moshe. He would live in Egypt. He would be the heart doctor of the king of Egypt. His nickname will be Rambam, Resh Mem Bet Mem. He's going to be very famous in Egypt. He's going to write a book called Mishneh Torah that is going to speak about 613 laws that God ordered Israel to keep.